A major storm is hanging over a big part of the country, threatening to make holiday travel a bit of a nightmare.
And it comes as airports kick off the two biggest travel days on record. This is what we're talking about. Storms stretching from the south all the way through the Midwest to the Northeast. Everything from rain, high winds, even tornadoes are possible.
And this video just into the newsroom of one of those storms. Thousands of people right now waking up in central Mississippi without power after strong winds and possible tornadoes hit the Jackson area there. Trees are down and homes are damaged as well. Let's get right out to CeCe, who's been at MSP all morning long. And CeCe, what's the status of those delays? Are we seeing any at all yet?
Yeah, not too many disruptions just yet, guys. But let's take a look here at the board. If we look at departures right now, we're seeing a lot of on time, which is great. But if we go over to the flights that are coming into MSP, we do have a couple of cancellations and a couple of delays. Two cancellations, two delays. That's up one from when I talked to you about half an hour ago. But with everything that's going on with this storm and possible changes, really make sure you're checking with your airline directly for the latest updates about those delays and cancellations. But if we take a look around the airport terminal one this morning, it has died down pretty significantly since I last talked to you. But here's what's being done so you can have as few travel hiccups as possible. The National Weather Service is positioning meteorologists at 22 FAA centers so they can give down to the minute weather predictions. Meanwhile, the Department of Transportation says it's been working closely with airlines to ease the cost of trip delays. Also, several airlines are beefing up staff this week, including here at MSP. We've seen a lot of people on the floor here. We're already seeing extra staff as well.
So far this year, we've already seen some record-breaking volume in terms of some of those summer holidays. And so far, the system has held up quite well. Cancellations this year actually below what they were before the pandemic. We're pressing the airlines and watching closely to see if they can keep that record up.
And then more tips for travelers. Make sure you're getting to your flight extra early, even earlier than maybe the 2 hours that you're supposed to be here before your flight. Also, consider signing up for TSA PreCheck so you can skip those lines. And keep in mind that the busiest travel times this week will be today, tomorrow, and then that's Sunday right after Thanksgiving. Guys.
All right. Great advice. CeCe Gaines reporting live from MSP Airport for us. We thank you.
All right, let's take a closer look at that storm here on the map, John. I see it's kind of over the Midwest right now. Where is it heading and how much of an impact is it going to have?
Sure. I mean, so we're looking at this thing. It's mainly a rain event. In my opinion, you're going to have bigger problems if you're driving. If you're driving into Michigan, that's going to be a spot that's tough. Over towards Cleveland, you're going to be running into some downpours. Almost guaranteed to have extra slowdowns from that on the driving time. Otherwise, flying, they're probably going to fly in until, unless we get storms or snow. So where are the storms possible? This is where you could have delays, probably not until the afternoon. I think you're unlikely to see delays until the storms fire. Of course, they develop typically in the afternoon. That's going to be down towards Panama City. If you're getting down towards Atlanta, Montgomery, just maybe Birmingham could get one of these. Columbia over to Raleigh. And I know Charlotte's obviously a big airport for, so Delta's Atlanta, American Airlines, of course, if you're flying into Charlotte, that's a hub there. Those are a couple of spots that I would watch this afternoon. So if you're watching now and you're just about to go to the airport, these are some spots we'll have to watch for that lower tornado threat, but it doesn't matter. If it's a storm that develops there, that will cause problems.